Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. After making this grinding wheel dresser last week, today I'm talking about back to basics with grinding wheels. In the UK, it's a requirement that people who use grinding wheels in industry are trained in the correct use and fitting of the grinding wheels. Did you know that nearly half of all accidents involving abrasive wheels are due to operator error or an unsafe system of work? So be safe in the workshop, always use safety glasses when grinding and a dust mask when necessary. I recommend that whatever country you're in, find out more about grinding wheels by going to the UK Health and Safety Executive website. The address will be coming up later in the video. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it.
Most of us in the workshop have a bench grinder like this. This one's a 6-inch diameter grinding wheel bench grinder. One side is the grinding wheel and on the other side it's got a wire brush. There will come a time when you need to replace the wheel or you need a different grade of wheel. And when you come to do that, I would advise going on the internet first and looking at the Health and Safety Executive's advice on use of abrasive wheels. There's lots of information in this catalogue. It's free to download. The only downside is it's 53 pages. But if you scan through it on the internet, you can pick up some useful information. Grinding wheels come in all different forms, shapes and sizes. So you've looked on the internet and you've decided you need a new wheel. Which do you choose? Grinding wheels are made from many different materials, depending on the application. You've got the grey carborundum wheels, the green silicon carbide, the pink wheels, the white aluminium oxide. So have a look at a supplier's catalogue and decide which material is suitable for the jobs you'll be grinding. The next thing you need to do is check your grinding machine and see the diameter, the width and the bore size you need. And most important, the speed, RPM or meters per second of the machine. This wheel was supplied with a grinding machine and is a carborundum wheel. And it shows you the speed on here is 3,450 RPM. This is over the speed of the machine, so it's suitable for fitting. The paper washers with a grinding wheel are called blotters because the paper is thick paper and is very similar to blotting paper. The label should give you the manufacturer's name, the type of machine the wheel can be fitted to, the date, the size, the type of material the wheel's made out of, the maximum speed of the wheel in meters per second or revs per minute. Now we come on to the flanges. The wheel's mounted to the bench grinder using the flanges. The bore does not transmit any power from the motor to the wheel. The flanges are the thing that grip the wheel and transmits the power to the wheel. The flanges are mounted on top of the blotter. The idea of the blotter is that it absorbs any irregularities in the wheel surface and helps to spread the load and the clamping force evenly over the surface of the wheel on both sides. Not all wheels need blotters. This wheel, which is a diamond grinding wheel, has the diamonds impregnated on an aluminium back and therefore does not need blotters. Now before we fit the wheel, we need to make sure there are no cracks. So we do a visual check that there are no cracks and then we'll do a ring test.
To ring test the wheel, take two screwdrivers. What we do is hold the wheel on the one screwdriver loosely. And then with the plastic part, just tap the wheel. It should ring like that. Same with the smaller wheels. It's ringing. If it was a cracked wheel, it would sound like this. Sound like a dull sound. This is my machine. 8-inch bench grinder. Two wheels, one's on the other side, which is the fine wheel, which I use for sharpening the lathe tools. This side is a coarse wheel for roughing out. The first thing you put on is your flange. Make sure it's clean, I've already wiped all this down. Fit your grinding wheel flange. Please note,
fit the blotters on each side of the wheel. With this wheel, the blotters are stuck to the wheel.
Then your grinding wheel. Then the other flange. This machine has a left-hand thread on this side, because when you put pressure on the wheel, you don't want the nut to start coming undone. And you don't need to tighten it with too much force. Just enough to clamp the wheel between the flanges. Turn it, if there's any run out, it doesn't hit your work rests. Before you start it, replace the guard on the outside. Plugged it in and switched the power on at the wall, but I haven't started it yet. I know that side is safe because I've used it before and it's run, but just having fitted this, maybe it's a new wheel and I don't know whether it's safe or not. I've rang it, it sounds okay. I can't see any cracks. So the first thing you do is stand to one side just in case, switch it on. The next thing I need to do is true that wheel up, and what I'm using to do that is it's a diamond dresser. You just rub it across the front of the wheel. You could use a single diamond
or a carborundum wheel dressing block or a diamond dressing block.
When I rub it on the wheel, it will take some of the wheel off. Obviously you need your safety glasses on. Because you're getting a lot of grit coming off, you may even need a mask.
When you've dressed the surface of the wheel all the way round, you need then to check your rest and make sure it's close to the wheel but not touching.
Now that's true in the wheel up, it's not balancing the wheel. I've not seen a bench grinder that you can balance the wheel on, because to balance the wheel you usually have small weights on a special flange that you can adjust around the diameter of the flange to move the weight into different areas where needed. And you also need a balancing spindle, and it's usually knife edges to balance it on.
Please do not try to true the wheel up by putting shims under the flanges. This is dangerous because it shifts the clamping force to a smaller area of the wheel and could result in the wheel cracking. Oh well, that's it for today. Don't forget to check out the website and stay safe in the workshop.